Watcher, and welcome to Said Stereo and the fourth episode of Designing and Building an Electric Guitar. In this episode, I'll be cutting out the body shape of the guitar. Progress has been impressively slow so far, but now I've got to the stage where my design has been turned into a template and the wood for the body of the guitar has been glued up and is ready for shaping. So firstly, I'm going to try to duplicate this template onto a chunkier piece of MDF. Next, I'll transplant the outline of the template onto the guitar body blank and roughly cut out the shape on the bandsaw. Once the body has been roughly cut out, I will attach the template to the wood and use it as a guide to trim the body flush with a router. Copying the template was a pretty easy job, and it was a good chance to test the simple router table that I'd put together on an old Black & Decker workmate. I'm using a spiral cutting router bit here with a half inch shank with ball bearings that rest on the template's surface. Copying the template like this also helped smooth out edges of the template that might not have been completely square. With the new template cut and not needing any further prep, I use it here to transfer the shape to the glued up body blank. Next, it's over to the bandsaw to roughly cut out the guitar body shape. I'm trying to keep fairly close to the line here, but far enough away that I don't risk cutting inside the line, as any slip up like that would be a time-consuming job to fix. Bandsaw that I'm using here is one of the cheapest that you can buy in the UK, and even with a good new blade, progress was slow and the finish was pretty rough. Still, it got the job done, and I was much happier using the bandsaw for this job than I would have been using a jigsaw or a coping saw. Before I took the body blank to the router table, I cleaned it up a bit on the oscillating sander. I'm trying to minimise the amount of material that is cutting away on the router table here, and I'm taking particular care out of elements such as the lower horn, where there's a risk of tear out from the router. Finally, it's time to attach the template to the body blank with masking tape and superglue. I've set up the router table so the bearing of the bit rests on the template, and I've made an acrylic guard that I can bring down to just above the workpiece, as I want to keep my fingers well away from the exposed router bit. I haven't had very much practice with this setup, so it took a while to gain confidence offering up the body blank to the router bit. A couple of times here, I didn't think through the best way to approach this and let the router pull the workpiece out of my hands. Luckily, no damage was done to the workpiece or the router or me, so I avoided any nasty chunks of tear out from the body. The final finish using this spiral cutting bit was just as I'd hoped it would be, leaving a smooth and precise copy of the template onto the guitar body. There are a few natural voids in the wood that have shown up here and there, and some fine sanding will be required down the line, but I'm really happy with how it turned out for a first try. So, with the basic shape of the guitar body finally emerging from this piece of horse chestnut, my attention now turns to the neck. Before I do anything with the neck, I wanted to check for flatness in the neck blank. At this point, I realised that I don't have any great way of checking for flatness, so I bought this Veritas straight edge that should be as accurate as I'll ever need it to be. As you might be able to see, there is a slight bow in the blank. In addition to this, no edge of the blank is particularly square, and as I'll be cutting a scarf joint for the headstock, I need to find a way to address these issues. But that's enough progress for one video, so I'll show you how I approach these tasks next time. Until then, take care and thank you for watching.